An apicectomy is a surgical procedure carried out under local anesthesia on an infected tooth. Again, literally, apicectomy means removal of the apex of the tooth. The root tip is sectioned under magnification with a microscope to address a persisting infection. The procedure is pain-free and done under good full anesthesia, and this permits to address the infection affecting the root tip, the last 3 millimeters. It is different from a re-root canal treatment, and this is carried out by, again, an endodontist with modern equipment and material which are way more biocompatible than it used to be. In the past, material did not allow removal of bacterial and creating an hermetic seal. Today, again, is a very predictable procedure which has a high success rate in the region of 80 to 95%. And this permits, again, to retain a tooth and maintain the tooth in place. The procedure is performed, again, using anesthetic first, a small incision in the gum, which will allow localizing the area of infection, removing a cystic tissue, and then address and fill the root tip. This is due to the presence of bacteria, which are present also in areas which are not accessible by the common re-root canal treatment. Again, the procedure is very straightforward and routinely carried out in the endodontic practice. An apicectomy is a surgical procedure that can be carried out when the first attempt of root canal treatment or re-root canal treatment failed. Basically, the infection of endodontic nature did persist or did reoccur. So an abscess following a root canal treatment or a re-root canal treatment did reoccur, or an X-ray shows persistence of bony lesion, of a periapical lesion within the bone. This is, again, a situation that can be addressed very efficiently with the surgical procedure, which aims directly at reaching the apex of the tooth and removing the infection directly. In certain cases, the bacteria are just present in an area which cannot be readily accessible, and they cannot be eradicated with the normal endodontic procedure, which are hard to grade, so from the top of the tooth to the bottom. In this case, again, bacteria can remain within lateral canals, dentinal tubules, areas which are just not possible to be cleaned efficiently with the normal endodontic procedure. In this case, again, the apicectomy, by removing the apical delta, the tip of the root, directly removes the cause and the source of the infection. In certain situations also, there are very large cysts or granuloma, which are foreign body reaction, which are basically harboring still bacteria are present within the bone. They cannot be healing spontaneously, so they need to be removed surgically and excised. In certain cases also, there might be crown warts, bridge works, or posts that don't allow an easy access to the infection because they cannot be dismantled or they cannot be drilled through efficiently. The first stage of an apicectomy is actually a consultation, meeting the patient in a non-operative setting, planning based on the individual patient needs and the clinical case presentation what the apicectomy will be like. So explain all the steps to the patient, make sure that there is a valid informed consent, and also explain the post-operative discomfort, which is actually minimal. After that, also a 3D CBCT scan, which is again an X-ray that gives a full CT picture of the tooth, will be prescribed in order to see the anatomy of the tooth. After that, there will be the actual operative procedure in another appointment most of the time, where first stage, which is the most important, is the provision of a full analgesia, so lack of any pain, any discomfort. Anesthesia will be provided for this reason, again, just local anesthesia, and this will permit a thoroughly comfortable procedure throughout, also for the post-operative treatment. After the anesthesia again is reached, which also provides hemostasis, a small incision is cut in the keratinized gum, which again is an area which heals very well and does not scar at all, luckily. After that, the cyst or granuloma, which is surrounding the root tip, will be removed, excised, and the root tip will be sectioned. By sectioning the root tip, again, the 3 millimeters at the apex, the bacteria will be removed efficiently. After that, biocompatible material will be placed after retroprepping with an ultrasonic device, and then the flap will be repositioned and sutured in place with resorbable or non-resorbable sutures. After that, the review will be arranged to make sure the healing is well underway in a week time, which is usually the case. A full healing is visible. And a final x-ray after a year will confirm the bone healing, which is usually a bit slower in comparison with the soft tissue healing. The episectomy usually it's a one and only treatment. It can be repeated in certain situations, however, it's rarely indicated because the success rate is actually very high, in the region of 80 to 95%. This is due to the very, again, efficient way to remove the bacteria once and for all by removing the infected portion of the tooth. In certain situations, episectomy were carried out in the past with old approaches, such as, again, the use of silver filling like amalgam. This did not provide a good biocompatibility and also allowed bacterial leakage. In this case, again, the procedure can be repeated very efficiently. Often the procedure was carried out without microscope, without microsurgical procedure. So repeating the actual episectomy, it's feasible and it does allow to eradicate all the remaining infection very efficiently without collateral damage to the tooth, and keeping a minimal invasive approach that permits removal of the bacteria. The cyst also can be excised very efficiently in a local anesthesia procedure without having to recur again to my major oral surgery approach. This is again indicated only in few cases, but most of the time one episectomy is enough to achieve the success and retaining the tooth, which is the most important thing.